Sometimes in an Angular app, we need to trigger something when the viewport gets resized. Like for this app, when we open our menu and then resize, maybe we want to close the menu automatically. How would you do this? Well, maybe you have some ideas, but with the Angular CDK, this is pretty easy. We can use the viewport ruler. It's a utility that deals with, you guessed it, the viewport. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use it. All right, let's get to it. Okay, so we already know the CDK provides many useful utilities, and the more we know about them, the easier our Angular development goes. The viewport ruler is yet another example of this. It may not be something you use every day, but it can definitely help out in certain situations. Take, for example, this demo site about the history of the band's shoe brand. We have this menu button here, and when we click it, the menu opens. And when we resize, it remains open. But let's pretend for a second here that our client wants us to hide this menu when the viewport is resized. Let's take a closer look at how this menu is toggled. Within our app component, we have our page content component, which contains everything we see in the page, including the menu button. When the menu button is clicked, we emit that event. When that event is emitted, we toggle the value of our menu visible property. When that property is true, we bind a class on our component, which contains a style for the visible state of the menu. So it's pretty straightforward, but it only toggles on button clicks right now. This is where the viewport ruler comes in. To use it, we first need to have the CDK installed. Then we need to have the viewport ruler imported in our component, and now we can use it. We start by injecting it in the constructor. Okay, now we can listen for a change with the change event observable. So we can wire this up right here in our constructor. We start by adding this dot viewport ruler dot change. And we can throttle our response to this change event so that it doesn't fire too often when resizing. Let's go with 300 milliseconds. Now this function returns an observable, so we need to destroy it when needed to prevent memory leaks. To do this, we need to add pipe and then take until destroyed. Okay, now we can subscribe to the event and properly toggle our menu visible property. So we add dot subscribe, open paren, close paren, and then our callback function. Now, under the hood, the viewport ruler uses a window resize event, which fires outside of Angular's change detection. In this case, since we need our variable value change to be reflected in the template, we need to make sure to run within NgZone. So we need to inject NgZone in the constructor. Then we add this.ngZone.run. And when this event fires, we just need to make sure that our property is set to false. Okay, so let's open the menu and then resize the viewport. There, it properly closes now. Let's look at it again. Click to open and then resize to close. Cool, so that was easy, right? And the viewport ruler actually provides more information too. In our case here, we don't need anything else, but there's more available if needed. To start, we can get the viewport rect, which provides an object containing the bottom, height, left, right, top, and width values of the viewport. Let's go ahead and log this out. It's accessed using the viewport rect method. Now, when we resize, we can see what this rect object looks like. Also, we can get the current viewport scroll position. Let's log this out this time. We do this with the get viewport scroll position method. Now let's scroll down a little bit. And when we resize this time, we can see this object consists of both the value we're scrolled vertically as well as the value we're scrolled horizontally. And we can also just get the viewport size if that's all that's needed. We do this with the get viewport size method. There, when we resize now, we get an object with the width and height of the viewport. So in this example, we were easily able to react to the viewport size changes and get all sorts of information about the viewport itself with the CDK viewport ruler. I hope you find this useful as you build things in Angular. Like I said earlier, the more you know about this stuff, the better and easier your life will be. Until next time, thanks for watching.